Hold down. Hello and welcome. Look at my hair, look. I'm going to have to shave this all off again. I look about 50 years older. Yeah, I know. I look 50 years older than what I am. I look, what's that make it? 67, something like that. Hello, good evening, and welcome to Boo Gurgles with Bukes, Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry K. We're having a hold down. Yeah! A wooga! Hello, and good. That was a wooga for Pepsi O's 4, whatever his name is. He said, doing a wooga. I'm here to please, you know. I'm a hoe, that's what I am. I'm a hoe to my customers. Like, listen, while we're on about hoe, we've got a garden full of them here. We've got a hoe garden. Oh, baby. The missus and the mother-in-law. Stop it! We're having a hoe garden here. Now, would you believe I've never had the hoe garden? And it's kind of, you know, it seems everyone has. It seems anyone who's into their beers and have had a hoe garden. So I kind of have been missing out here, I reckon. But I'm going to give it a go. Unfiltered. That means probably unfiltered. Unfiltered is nice, I like that. It might mean it's slightly cloudy, but a lot of the time filtering, even with light filtering, you get some of the kind of flavour bits and pieces seem to be dragged out, especially some of the flavour oils, they seem to be dragged out of the beer. I'd rather have a cloudy flavoursome beer than, you know, a completely clear... What's that? Why am I BB getting hold of that? Oh. Here's something funny. Try the other one. Oh, BB don't like Hoe Garden. He don't like it. Just about gets his things under the teeth. Well, there's the bottle crown there. Quite pretty, I like that. It's kind of, you know, it's business-like. It does what it says on the bottle. Right, let's have a sniff before it all goes away. That actually smells quite nice. What have we got here? It's an InBev. Customer service InBev. I don't know whether they brew it or just distribute it or whatever. I would imagine they probably brew it, knowing them. But like I said before, right? Sometimes, just because the big names have got older things, they also do Leffy Blonde, Leffy Brun, you know, they do the Leffy beers as well. They do Maccas and Stout. Lovely. The kind of nostalgia for me that is, and they haven't messed it up. It's as good as I remember it being, and hopefully this will be just as good as well. As I said, I've not had it before, so or the beer. So hopefully it'll be fine and dandy. See, unlike Wells and Young's, I can't see any E numbers in this. So what have we got? Barley malt, wheat. I wish they would write it a bit bigger. I mean, obviously, they've got to get it down here in about 50 different languages. It's like the, what do you call it, Eurovision Song Contest here. 5.6. And all that business. Malted barley wheat. That's about all it says. I'd imagine there's water in there as well. Stop it, Terry. Flavoured with spices. Now, I think, if I remember rightly, they kind of, they put, what is it, some sort of orange or something, is it? I can't even remember. Shall I have a look now? Do you know what? It's not. Right, speaking of colourings, we won't get be getting that on view. E150s and everything else. Where you have to look at, see, instead of holding it up to the light to see what colour it is, you get your colour chart out of Dulux. Right, let's go for it, Till. See, I've put a mirror up here for a bit of lighting, and I'm ducking in and out of the... ducking in and out of the light now. Never mind. Still got me JR for rank curtain up behind, so that's always a good thing. Just in case I get a bit burlesque and start wrapping my legs around it and everything. Now I'm trying to pour this as nice and gentle as I can, because I mean, being a wheat beer, there's a lot of head holding proteins in there, so you're going to get a big crispy head on the top. Can't help that, I'm afraid. Should have left it a bit short so I could swell some of it. But that looks beautiful. See, that looks absolutely wonderful. Right, a lot of you go, oh, if you don't know about beers, you'll go, it looks a bit like this one. You know, there's a lovely little creamy head developed on the top there. Looks a bit complunky from the side, but from the top, nice and creamy. Now, just a quick... I don't know if you can see these lines here. Half pint, third pint, you know. When you go to your beer festivals, don't go having pint, because you won't, you'll get to try like an handful of beers and then be flat on your back, you know. Whereas if you have thirds of pints, you can have big loads of beers, you know, and try out all sorts, and you'll be still be alright, because you'll be walking around in between. Right, let's have a sniff. Getting a lot of lovely wheatiness, but I'm also getting... It smells smooth. If anything can smell smooth. It smells balanced and smooth. It smells... nice and kind of like buttery biscuity, that sort of thing, you know, the shortbread biscuits. I'm going to dive in, I'm getting a... like this. Listen, I haven't got this really cold, but I don't like things cold, and I think if you're going to quench your thirst, sometimes, the warmer you have it, the wetter it seems the drink gets. I don't know whether it's because the oils wake up or what, but it sometimes seems the drinks are wetter, and they quench your thirst when they're at room temperature. So there you go. Oh, I say. Oh, that's lovely. It's, that's nice. I like that. That there is a cure for lager. That one. That's a cure for lager. I've always thought that some of the wheat beers... a cure for lager. The only trouble is lager drinker will see that. When I say lager drinker, I'm not having to go at all lagers. I'm just on about the Popsy McLagers, the ones that are mass produced, you know, mass indoctrinated, multimedia ad campaigns in a bottle, you know, or in a can usually. And you get them, and there's really not a lot of flavour difference between any of them. You know, people say, oh yeah, I only drink so-and-so, but do you? Because I've had me lager mates have been having a beer with me before, and I've served them up a Carlsberg instead of a Carling or instead of a Foster's, whatever, and they haven't known the difference. Not at all. They've just been, oh yeah, lovely. I'm upsetting people here, and I am. But no, I'm not having to go at all lagers. But if you served something like that in a pub, and kind of, you know, educate the people somehow on the adverts, maybe, that it doesn't matter if it's a bit cloudy. There's the proteins in the wheat and stuff, you know. And also, there may even be a little bit of the old yeast floating around as well. As long as it ain't lumps, bumps and carbuncles, you know. The yeast adds a bit of flavour sometimes. But that there is not the yeast, that's the proteins in the wheat. See, with barley, there's a lot of starch and not so many proteins, so it's kind of a lot more beer friendly. You know, wheat is where the proteins are there, it's a lot more bread friendly. You know, I make my own bread as well, you know. So you can really get that elasticity and all that, you know, with the wheat proteins. So anyway, rambling on. There's a little bit of kind of like a distant cardamom, like a more fruity sort of floral spice, like a distant cardamom, maybe some sort of orange peel or something like that in there, and a distant quince. But all these kind of things, they're really, really subtle. They're really subtle and gentle. There's a big, massive, hefty, bready, biscuity, wheat sort of flavour there. And a lovely, smooth, sort of buttery finish to it. See, sometimes you say butter and people are already thinking of, oh, you know, nasty this and nasty that. Because there's certain descriptives in the beer world and that butter and, you know, it can mean a bad thing. But when I say I'm meaning it's like smooth. Pardon me. Ooh, those burps are nice. Smooth and laid over the palate, you know, buttered over the palate. All in all, that is a marvellous beer. I like that. It's not what I call one of these flavours sort of smack in the mouths and that. But that cooled down. You do need it cooled down, this one. That cooled down and had out on the porch and that, or on the porch, outside. That's where your porch usually is. With a little bit of a barbecue and that or something, you know. That would go down a treat. Even like indoors with a nice salad or something. Something light. Beautiful. Anyway, chin chin. Cheers to you out there. Tap. Cheers. Chin chin. Bottoms up.